The next three factors aren't quite as complex, so I went ahead and grouped them into a category just called others. So let's go ahead and start with that third factor that affects acidity, and that would be resonance effects. All right? So resonance effects is actually just really easy. It's just whenever the donation of a proton leads to the formation of a possible resonance structure, okay, that conjugate base will be more stable. And the reason that that conjugate base will be more stable is because it can resonate. And remember that resonance structures enable for a charge to be in multiple places. So that would make sense that it's delocalizing the charge, all right? And that means that if the conjugate base is more stable, then the molecule will be a better acid. Okay? So check this out. For this example, I've given you two OH bonds. Okay, so I have OH and I have OH. All right, so we're not going to use pKa's to figure this out. It says, which of the following pairs of acids would have the lower? But I'm not asking you to remember it. I mean, even though you do, you should remember it. But I just want to use the factors affecting acidity to figure this out. So for both of these, do they have different element effects? Remember, the element effect is the atom that's directly attached to the H. So in this case, they both have the same element effect. So I'm just going to write that here. Same element effect. Okay? And the reason is because they both have an oxygen attached to an H. That doesn't change. All right? So the size, the electronegativity is exactly the same. But it turns out that one of these is a much better acid. In fact, one of these is called carboxylic acid, and the other one is just an alcohol. So what is it about the carboxylic acid that makes it so much better as an acid? And it's the fact that, let's look at the conjugate bases. The conjugate base for my carboxylic acid looks like this. O negative, okay? The conjugate base, so I'm just gonna put here, this is CB, conjugate base, all right? The conjugate base for my alcohol looks like this. All right? So which of these is going to be the one that's more stable? Well, both of them have a negative charge on the O. But notice that this O is stuck. This one, that negative charge isn't going to be able to go anywhere, so it's completely localized. Whereas on the other one, this one is actually going to be able to resonate using the two arrow rule that I taught you guys in resonance structure. So then I would make a bond there, and I would break a bond there, and I would actually get a new resonance structure that looks like this. And sorry, it's a little bit crowded. I would get a new resonance structure that looks like that. So what that means is that I'm able to distribute this negative charge over those three atoms. Isn't that interesting? So what that means is that one of them is going to be way more stable than the other, and that is why carboxylic acid has a pKa of 5, whereas alcohol has a pKa of 16. That's a huge difference. Really, if it weren't for the carbonyl, that would still have, that carboxylic acid would have a pKa of 16. But the carbonyl changes it so it can resonate. So now the pKa is basically like a trillion times better. Or like in terms of it's like a trillion times more acidic. Almost a trillion, all right? So it's literally a way better acid. So that's called the resonance effect. Anytime you can make resonance structures, it comes into play.